They can be in this at any moment. They just gotta up their mental game, let their talent speak.
Amazing placement. What a shot.
A gutsy overhead.
Aspect of mental toughness here that's just different.
I like the body language of all four players.
Oh, look at that shot! Great hands from Kiro.
Hello, and welcome to the 2023-24 APTA Tour presented by Volley. We are live from the Country Club in Brookline, Massachusetts, bringing you the 2024 APTA Boston Nationals presented by Aon. Boston Nationals is the 16th and the last stop on the 2023-24 APTA Tour, with live streaming brought to you by the APTA membership, the APTA National Sponsors Volley Infusion, and local sponsors, local presenting sponsor Aon, secondary court sponsor Santo Tequila, local sponsors Bully Boy Distillers, Columbus Overgroup, Biega and Kilgore Team Compass, Hillary Maddox Team Compass, Crestwood Advisors, DraftKings, FB Insurance Services Incorporated, Harpoon, Needham Bank, Norfolk and Denham Insurance, Pure Insurance, UBS, WAC, and Winstanley Enterprises. I'm Lauren Mandel, along with Patty Hogan, and we are here with the women's finals between the number one seeds, Lynn Burrish and Macy Elliott, and the number four seeds, Gabby Nicolescu and Ellie Halbauer. Hi, Patty.
Good morning, Lauren. And we have a treat. We have Brad Easterbrook out on the court going to do a pre-match interview, and we have a special rendition of the national anthem sung by George Carroll, longtime the Country Club member here and proud captain of the men's B team.
All right. Is there we see Brad ready with all of his questions.
Hello, this is Brad Easterbrook here at the finals of the 2024 APTA Nationals. All right, and we're excited for the women's final coming up. Our number one seeds, Burrish and Elliott, against the number four seeds of Halbauer and Nicolescu. And we're looking forward to a great match out here at the Country Club in Brookline. They've done an amazing tournament all weekend long. It's been filled with energy and just a great atmosphere all the time with Johan Durant's induction into the Hall of Fame and the whole works. We're going to do a quick pre-match interview with all the players before we get started. So I'm going to call over Gabby Nicolescu and Ellie Halbauer. This is our number four seeds. Hey, guys, congratulations. This is the culmination of a lot of work on the entire year. And in the beginning of the season, you guys started. You've had great results all season, but have struggled to beat the top one or two teams, but here at the end, you've come through and you've had a great result. What's it like been putting in the work to do that?
Well, you know, we knew that's gonna happen. We were hoping this is the best outcome we were hoping for. We're glad we're in the situation to play for a title. Ellie's amazing and I'm very happy to be here, and I hope we give them a run for their money.
Well, that's terrific. And Ellie, this is your first final.
Yeah.
And it's been just like a growth experience throughout the entire year. What's it like? How are you feeling today?
Well, I'm very excited to play. Gabby's helped me a lot. I feel like I've improved so much this season from Gabby just helping me on the court, and I'm ready to get out there today.
Can I say hi to my Reading fans, Reading Country Club, and my husband? Thanks for watching the kids.
Well, you sure can. Give a shout out.
Shout out to Kenwood Country Club.
All right, terrific. And these are our number four seeds, Gabby Nicolescu, Ellie Halbauer. Good luck today, ladies.
Thank you.
And let's bring in our defending national champions. Here we go, Lynn Burrish, Macy Elliott. Well, congratulations, guys. Again, for you guys, you're always sort of, I guess we'll say, projected to get to this point. You started the season, you've had great results all year, but in the beginning, it took a little while to figure a couple of things out. In the second half of the season, you've really been dominating. What's it been like? Did you have conversations? You've been watching film? Do you guys get to practice together all the time?
I think the difference between the first half and the second half is we really kind of just allowed ourselves to play freely without putting pressure on ourselves. You know, the first half was all about, you know, we're defending national title, defending national champions, and we wanted to kind of keep our mark there, but then we were kind of just like, let's play paddle, and it's worked this far. So.
Well, terrific. Did you make any strategy changes along the way?
Not necessarily strategy changes, but I think I'm really proud of how I think we've improved a lot this year. We switched sides, we learned different roles, we both worked on our serves, and we've put a lot of work into it, so we're really proud of how we've done so far.
Well, the work has certainly shown, and here we are with our defending national champions, and we're getting ready for the women's final here at the Country Club in Brookline, Massachusetts. Thanks, ladies. Good luck.
Thank you, Brad.
If not, Lauren Mandel has said that she would be willing to sing it. Lauren, did we talk about that?
I assure you, there's no time of day that anybody wants to hear that.
There's tour director Jackie Cameron in the red jacket. She's done a phenomenal job throughout the 16-stop APTA tour for the 23-24 season. Remarkable composure, what a wise woman, a lot of wisdom, and you can see she stays in shape.
She's warming up amazing.
Whatever the players do, she mimics that behavior, so watch out. I'm looking forward to her cartwheel next.
Good morning, everyone. Welcome to the APTA National Paddle Tennis Championship. And at this time, it's my pleasure to introduce George Carroll to sing the national anthem.
Attention, mesdames et messieurs, levez-vous s'il vous plaît pour l'hymne national de l'État-Unis. Ladies and gentlemen, please rise for the national anthem of the United States of America. The national anthem is behind that building there. You can't see it, but it's there. Gentlemen, if you're wearing hats, please take them off. Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming. And the
from Cincinnati, that's Ellie Haubauer. And she is hitting the ball straight ahead at Lynn Kerr on the pink sneakers. Forget about that. They're just going to go right over to Ellie's partner, Gabby Niculescu, who plays that ad court. Gabby is a three-time national champion, no stranger to the stage, having played in six national final matches already in her career. And this, you know, the men's and women's tournament at this year's Nationals is so unique, Lauren, because of the age of the players. Gabby is the oldest participant in the women's final at 37. Macy is 29. Lynn is 28. And Ellie, Gabby's partner, is only 26. So big change in the women's game and the men's game at the top. And that's a great shot. Lynn Kiro to the right of that picture. That's Macy Hoops Elliott over there. On the left side, she's called Hoops for those earrings, obviously. They are our women's defending national championship team. Just a remarkable year. They played in eight finals. They got off to a little bit of a slow start. They lost in the first four finals and then just have been on a run, and they've been invincible. You know, overtook Hanishin Zabori, who held the number one ranking in our sport for about 2.5 years, Lauren. and Burris and Elliott, they've kept their foot on the gas the second half of the season. And they look, you know, unbeatable to many, many people out here. You know, on the other side of the draw, here you have, you know, Niculescu and Halbauer, who came through this draw and pulled that monster upset off over Hanish Sabori. And let's take a look at the draw, their path to the draw, Lauren. So with Halbauer, Niculescu, you can see they started with a bye. You know, the big match that defined them for me was that Cruz Lopez 6-0-6-0 match. Cruz and Lopez played a pretty decent match, believe it or not. And that was where I just saw the emergence of Ellie Halbauer out here. She just was phenomenal, took over that match, and that gave her so much confidence heading into that semifinal where they pulled off that 6-3 win over Hanish and Sabori. Burris and Elliott, they took out two Hall of Famers in that round of 16 match, Zink and Prendergast. Again, 0-0, but, you know, really phenomenal play, really entertaining points, and great to have Hall of Famers in this tournament. And Prendergast, Zink, the longest running team who's played in this national championship besides Duran and Mitchell on the men's side. So quite a remarkable achievement for Prendergast and Zink. Quarterfinals, they took out Alexander and Lalic. Lalic 6-2, 6-3, and then they had that win in the semis, Lauren, that you called yesterday over Morgan and Sikora, 6-3 and 6-4.
Yeah, I mean, and I called actually their last three matches, and I have to say, you know, look, they have been unbeatable in the second half of the season. Their Burris and Elliott they have no holes in their game. They've improved everything. They both have excellent serves that you can't attack, and they look unbeatable. However, both Alexandre and Lalic and Morgan and Sikora played really, really good matches against them, and you know, they both had their chances in the second set, and all credit to Burris and Elliott for making those scores look a lot less close than the matches actually were. You know, even when their opponents look like they may be closing in to take the second sets, they just ended up shutting them down. But I will be interested to see how Niculescu and Halbauer do today. I mean, as you said, Niculescu is a known quantity, 6 national finals. I mean, she's been at the top of the game for years now. But Halbauer is really the wild card here. And obviously, she's improved tremendously this year, and it's helped her so much to have such an experienced partner in Gabby Niculescu. But will we see Burris and Elliott make her look like the most inexperienced player on the court?
Yeah, you know, Lauren, this all started in 1935. Mrs. Henry Eaton and Mrs. Percival Fuller took out Mrs. F.M. Hampton and Mrs. Rockefeller, 1-1, to claim the first women's national championship. You know, the sport has just evolved. It's just remarkable, the growth, the level of participation and level of expertise. Lauren, you're a great player in your own right, and you know, you just see the transition in the game, and you see these players who come into the game with such a high level skill set. I mean, it's incredible. And I think, you know, they're just coming in, and I think thanks to so many teaching pros and so many experienced players who take players under their wing, it allows for this very quick ascent in the sport. Where, you know, you think about Macy Elliott. She won in Darien and, you know, her first national title. And, you know, she was a newbie. She was on the court. It was her second year on the court. Same with Lynn Burris. You know, these women just came into this sport with, like, such a skill set rackets-wise, but mostly, you know, a mentality about a game, the game, and an understanding of the game that just seemed like they just had a shortcut, you know, path to excellence and being national champions after only playing this sport a few years. It's a remarkable achievement. I think Halbauer and Niculescu, you know, they played 4 Grand Prix tournaments only. They didn't play anywhere near as many tournaments, half, you know, as Elliott and Burris. And Ellie Halbauer, that's a great shot from her. She's a wonderful player from Cincinnati area. She turned pro tennis at age 15, played on the tour for 10 years. She teaches, she's in charge of all the kids programs for tennis at Kenwood Country Club, and she's very involved with the paddle, with the women's teams and the men. So she's fully immersed and so passionate about paddle, and you just see it, and she has a wonderful personality. You can just see that she just oozes kind of like a casual confidence out on that court, and she's gonna need that today to match up, because this match is going to come down to her, I think, Lauren.
Yeah, I mean, we've seen the last few times we've seen Elliott and Burris play Hanish and Zabori, and let's face it, that's, I mean, I think 100% of the people would have thought that that would have been the final today. So all credit to Halbauer Niculescu for taking out Hanish and Zabori. Let's see what the umpire is saying.
Between games, and it wasn't a change in hands. Does that bother you? Can you say something to people about not?
Thank you.
And this will be a letter.
The umpire's asking if something would bother Macy Elliott. Typical answer. Nothing bothers me.
Not bother. She said, let the people move around. Anyway, so when Burris and Elliott the
Ladies
last few
and
times.
Gentlemen,
and here we go
final
with the umpire.
Round match of the APTA Nationals is best of three sets with tie breaks. To my left in the forehand court, from Cincinnati, Ohio, Ellie Halbauer, and her partner in the backhand court from Norwalk, Connecticut, Gabby Niculescu. To my right, from Morris Plains, New Jersey, in the backhand court from North Plains, New Jersey, Lynn Burris. Her partner in the forehand court from Wilton, Connecticut, Macy Elliott. Halbauer and Niculescu won the toss and elected to receive. Lynn Burris will serve.
So Lauren, interesting they chose to receive, you know, in their semifinal win over Hanish and Zabori. You know, we were talking about, you look at the serving technique and the depth of Hanish and Zabori, the spins they can hit. They had
clarification, third set will be played out, no tiebreaker.
How about Halbauer Niculescu? But the irony is, it came down to the third set, and there were five straight breaks. And we were commenting that we thought maybe the first person who held serve, their team would win, and that was the case. Ellie Halbauer was the first one to hold serve in that deciding third set. And then, you know, they broke Hanish and again, and then Gabby actually held serve as well to close out that third set, 6-3, in the semifinals. So, you know, I think with the return of serve power of Burris and Elliott,
well, that's Leskin the thing, right?
Halbauer, I mean, it just decided it was a wise choice to return and not put themselves in a precarious spot right from the beginning, Lauren.
It's interesting, you know. Both Burris and Elliott have such good serves that you can't attack their serve generally. I mean, sometimes, you know, their serves will come up high in the screen and you can attack them off the screen. But for the most part, it takes away a shot that a lot of the women, and both Niculescu and Halbauer, love to return. And it's not so easy to attack these returns. It really takes away some offense from a lot of the players, whereas Halbauer and Niculescu serve are more attackable.
Lauren, that's a great point. And I think the strength of Burris, the strength of Niculescu Halbauer is exactly their return of serves.
Yeah.
And these serves can negate it, to your point. And, I mean, that could be a huge difference, because I do believe that Halbauer and Niculescu, you know, as they got into the match more and more, it was because Halbauer kept her foot on the gas and actually started applying a lot of pressure. I mean, she's wonderful. She can hit, you'll see soon. She can hit her forehand. She's got a big range. She's got that two-handed backhand crushing shot. So she can hit it. So I'll just look for her to come out and play with a sort of an aggressive mindset. They're not going to give her that many opportunities, I wouldn't think. And we're off. Niculescu to start. We're not off. Never mind.
We're not off.
Time up.
Sorry.
We're about to be off.
Yep.
I think. Burris is serving, I believe.
Yeah, so I really think Halbauer is the key in this match. I think her baseline play is going to be the key, her screen play. She's newer in the sport, and Burris and Elliott have some of those overheads that can attack and go after a player in that deuce court. So Halbauer is really going to have to step up to the plate there. And then we'll talk about net play as they become the serving team, Lauren.
I'll be surprised if Burris and Elliott let Halbauer's drives be a factor in this match. I just can't imagine they're going to, A, give her many balls to drive, and B, I think they'll shut down her drive. But But, you know, I would have thought the same against Hanish and Zabori. So we'll see.
Yeah, I think the difference is that Macy Elliott, I have found her to be a remarkable player at the net in the second half of the season with her volleys. Mm-hmm. They're both phenomenal mm-hmm. volleyers. But Macy does a wonderful job of cutting off that middle drive, that ball coming mm-hmm. from cross court from where, you know, Haballer would be hitting. So we'll look for that as well.
I have other ones.
I think Niculescu and Haballer tend to play off the net more, Lauren. We talked about it a little bit pregame.
Okay, I got other ones.
And so we'll see about that. But I think Macy, you know, when I've seen her, her success against Zaborian Hanish is because she's so zeroed in, particularly in that match on a Zaborian, taking away her drive. By every time she's seeing it, she really closes in and puts herself in the best possible volley position.
And, as I started to say before, the last few times they've played Hanish and Zabori, they didn't give Zabori any drives. They isolated the forehand side,
hey,
and they made Hanish, you know, try to beat them from there. And I have a feeling that's what they're going to do again today. So, on the forehand side. So we will see. Here's Lynn Burris to serve.
Right, and for those of you who watch a ton of women's paddle, you know, I think the strategy that Burris and Elliott will have out there,
love.
It could be close to how you play Henderson Zabori, so we'll see about that. Where a lot of plays go to the deuce court, but maybe not. Right
and that's how you have to attack their serve. You have to let it go in the screen. It's the only way to do it.
You're right. That ball is just bouncing up and goes so high, so hard to control and get down. So letting it go through off of the screens gives you the ability to create an offensive moment versus being totally on the defensive. So that's what
30 love.
We're going to see a lot of.
That's what we knew we had to look for, Patty, is that roller, how Haubauer can manage the roller and the combination of overheads that are going to come at her in that corner.
I feel like Haubauer needs to borrow some goalie gear from the Boston Bruins goalie because she's going to get battered out here. From Niculescu.
40-15.
Kind of caught Macy Elliott almost backing off on that volley a little bit. Just when I was boasting about what a phenomenal volley was.
Yeah, it was a very uncharacteristic look from Macy Elliott.
Yeah, she had a weird miss.
Yeah.
So that's Haballer in the red pants hitting that overhead and back of Niculescu. We've seen this formation often over the years with Gabby Niculescu playing the left side of the two players at the net when you look at them from this view. And this is where it's going to be interesting
40,
to see
30.
What success they have because Haballer, and she's her partner in that setup, doesn't really close the net very much. So it could be a real vulnerable spot for them. It's a little warmer day than yesterday, and thankfully the rain has stopped, and we have ideal playing conditions currently for the women's finals. That's what I'm talking about. Haballer, when she does get that short ball, she will fire, as will Niculescu. And this is what I wanted to see them just hit consecutive drives because they could be like playing against the volleyball machine out here. You know, they could drive 20 balls in a row and make 20. And I think they're going to have to be able to apply some pressure and really spot their drives in order to break down the phenomenal defensive abilities of Burris and Elliott. That was a great point for Haballer and Niculescu.
Deuce!
Yeah, I mean, you saw...
Oh, go ahead, Lauren.
you saw a little bit of their firepower there. They hit, you know, four or five really good drives that Elliott and Burrish fought off. And that's what we're going to see.
Yeah, and I like the play from Niculescu in there. She kind of just lobbed a lot of shots. She hit a down-the-line lob over there in the prior point, and that's what she's going to have to do. If Niculescu can, like, move around her lobs from the baseline, I think then she's going to be able to create a lot of offensive looks for their team. I think if Burris and Elliott zero in over there on Haubauer, it's going to be far less likely.
Advantage, Burris, Elliott.
I think Niculescu is used to dictating play, both at the net and from the baseline. But, you know, when you have the overheads and the, you know, the overhead placement and variety from Burris and Elliott, it makes it so much tougher. And you can see how Macy Elliott just slides to her right, Lauren. No confusion whatsoever who's going to hit that ball. And this is where Niculescu, as the match went deeper yesterday against Sanish and Zabori, did a little better job as the match went on of moving that lob around a little bit. Oh boy, there's the Haubauer.
There's the drive we're talking about.
Yep.
There was a little confusion. I like that backhand slide off the screen that Niculescu's hitting. Going down to the volleyers. Yeah, they looked good that first game. That was a good display from them. And if Elliott and Burris are going to hit overheads that bounce high into the screens, it's going to be tough going for them.
Niculescu to serve. Macy Elliott returning from the deuce court. Ellie Haubauer hitting the overhead. Lynn Kiro throwing up a lob out of that ad court. See, I think the overhead coverage is a little suspect for Niculescu and Haubauer because they haven't really played that much. That Macy Elliott is as good as anyone in the game. You know, at being able to spot her shots, and she sees the court, and you can see she's bouncing all over there. She's even if four shots in a row go to burst, you see Elliott always bouncing and always being ready. Very much like Flor Hanisch out of that deuce court, and both of them are brilliant at opening up the court, you know, through a series of variety of lobs, chips. You know, and
love 15.
Lots of those little shorter types of shots hit that are meant to take away time from your opponent's reaction time. Where, you know, when you see Haubauer and Niculescu, there's not many nuances to their game. It's sheer power or a lob. You know what I mean? It's not the in-between kinds of shots. And I think Elliott will be...
Although I feel like Niculescu's hitting that, you know, backhand off the screen where she just kind of slides it down, which is like that cut.
Yeah.
love 30.
And that's the problem with their net coverage. I saw this yesterday. You know, they both, you see Elliott coming out of that deuce court with an offensive shot. And neither of them really closed in to get themselves in a better volley position. So not only do you make errors, but it makes it really tough to volley deep from that far back. And those short shots against a team like Elliott and Burns are just going to get crushed. That's going to hurt you big time. The other thing I was talking about yesterday, when the match turned a little bit with Henderson Zabori in the semis, I felt it was that Niculescu and Hauballer went to this setup where Hauballer in the red pants played more in the left position at
love
the net,
40.
Taking more of the overheads because it allowed Niculescu to defend the, you know, the middle drive coming from that deuce court player. And Niculescu is a wonderful volleyer and does commit really early to that backhand volley and gets
yes.
natural depth as a function of that really early decision to stay with her backhand. Hauballer still goes back and forth a lot, and as a result kind of gets herself sort of in some tricky volley positions.
Game Burris Elliott, 2-love.
You know, I was thinking in this match, it was critical for Hauballer Niculescu as the number 4 seed and more than a slight underdog in this match, you know, to get a good start, because Burris Elliott, they know how to win. They know how to close out matches long. I feel like as soon as they start on the board where they can have
love.
A 2-game margin here, they're going for 3, they're going for 4, they're going for 5. I don't ever see them as a team just kind of like settle in and play out the set. They want to be as dominant as possible
yep.
score-wise.
And you see that serve from Macy Elliott. I mean, we talk about it in every match, but, you know,
love.
She used to just have a serve that she just pushed in to keep it low, and she's added this serve, and it's probably the best serve in the game now. Certainly one of them,
yeah.
Along with Burris.
Right, amazing. Woman wins the national championship, and what does she go do? Change her serve. How great is that? And that's why these players are at the top of the game, and these women just keep adding new shots to their arsenal all the time, because if they don't add a new shot, the other team is going to do it, and then they don't match up well. So I love how
40 love.
You know, Hanish Sabori have done a beautiful job in this sport, dominated the game for a couple of years, and really helped push the level of play up. Incredible athleticism out there.
Game.
All right.
Burris Elliott. They lead the first set 3-love.
Lauren, Aon is so proud to be the title sponsor of the APTA National Championships. Aon exists to shape decisions for the better. They provide their clients with advice and risk and human solutions that give them the clarity and confidence to make better decisions to protect and grow their business. Aon is in the business of better decisions. And that's what we need. You know, this match, I think paddle comes down to phenomenal decision making. All of these women have so much talent.
Yep.
You know, and we look at, you know, the newbie on the court, Hauballer. I think I'm going to change how I say her name to Hauballer right now. We've been tipped off that we were saying it the second
okay.
favorite way to say it. So we'll go with her favorite way to say it. Hauballer. It's good to find these things out before the tournament ends. Things with Hauballer,
yeah.
with her overhead line, you see what I marvel at with Elliott, Burris, you know, they have some different kinds of overheads they hit.
Yeah.
You know, she's got the phenomenal roller that she just, you know, is a crushing shot. Then she kind of has a little push shot. And that's a new shot from Niculescu.
Yes.
She went over
yes.
to her continental grip, way off her Western or oh. semi-Western. You know, to hit that overhead, and she's added that overhead in the game. This match is going to come down to Hauballer, because she's going to get a million opportunities, and I just haven't seen that variety in the overheads.
Well, she has that, you know, Eastern grip. It's hard to, you can't get any spin. Like you said, Niculescu added that, and she's moving her grip over. But Halbauer right now can't hit different overheads with that grip. She can roll. She has a great roller, and she can hit that good push overhead, and she's been hitting it well and aiming it well. But you're not going to see the variety that you see from some of the other players.
Right. I'm concerned that she doesn't necessarily have that awareness right in the moment when you need possibly to hit a reset type of a shot when you're really deep to give herself more time to get in a better volley position. So I'll look for that, you know, throughout this match.
So what are Halbauer and Niculescu going to do with the net to win points? You know, Niculescu has that great roller, but Burris and Elliott are very adept at handling it. How are they winning their points at the net?
So one of the things Halbauer has to do is she has to get her feet set so she can hit an overhead with more pace and spin possibly into Burris's side screen. You know, attack that screen and try to back up Burris, because Burris has just the forehand of life, which you will see as this match goes on.
15-30.
And so I'm not sure that Halbauer has that overhead yet. You know, it's still in development, I think. And so that's the struggle. And as you pointed out, with her Eastern grip, and if she doesn't really get a little bit more sideways, she's not going to avail herself of the possibility of being able to hit that ball over into the side back screen of that ad court. And that'll just feed into Burris's strengths.
You know, 30 all.
Yeah, you saw some of the Burris forehands there. She hit a wild one to end that point.
Right. And
30 all.
So strategy-wise, Lauren, you know, this is going to be interesting for all of us to see what they come up with. Because they tend to, like you can see, they're both way off the net. And I'll be curious to see, you know, I would expect it to come a little bit more from Macy Ellen in the deuce court. You know, there was like a little chip type of shot from Burris, and I think that's going to be the shot that, you know, both of them own that can kind of move Halbauer and Niculescu up and back and up and back, where I don't see that Halbauer can force Elliott and Burris to do that, you know, from the other side of it. So just, you know, it is daunting. And right there you saw Ellie Halbauer. Again, she was
30,
right off the net line.
40.
See how she has happy feet? Like she dances a little bit. So she loves the DJ in between points or in between games and changeovers here. Country Club of Brookline has done a beautiful job. Really a fun, festive vibe at all times out here. The DJ goes away.
Ooh.
Oopsie, the DJ goes away while they're playing. But, whoopsie. What just happened there, Lauren?
Ellie, I'm going to give a warning for that.
He missed her serve and got
got a little frustrated.
Angry. Yeah.
And that was a good
game
move, too, for the umpire
Burris
to get Elliott. Her
they lead the
warning.
First set for love.
Just, you know, frustration from Ellie right there. Down 4-0 in the first set of this national championship final. You know, this is a nightmare start for Halbauer and Niculescu, but they've got to keep it in check. They're monster underdogs coming into this match. They're going to have to keep their composure and discipline here. And, you know, Lauren, when you look up and you see Burris and Elliott on the other side, what do you do? You know, you ask me that question, I have no idea. They don't miss. That's how good they are. And so, but you need the combination of spins on overheads to break them down, and I just don't think we're going to get that from Niculescu and Halbauer here today.
That's the issue. And the pace that they come at you with, Niculescu and Halbauer, doesn't bother Ellie and Burris. They're bring it on. They don't mind the pace.
15 love.
And Niculescu, pretty amazing, Lauren. They played the 4 Grand Prix events this year. They beat everybody in the sport except the top 2 teams. Now they played, you know, Burris and Elliott twice this season. Wasn't close the first time. Second time, close three-setter. They lost 6-1 in the third set. So I think that gave them, you know, some confidence. And in the Fulton Cup on Thursday, in an abbreviated format, first of four, I think they ended up Niculescu and Hallbauer beat Burrs and Elliott 5-4. So it wasn't a 2-out-of-3 set match, not a long grind under rain conditions, so a little tough to go by, but it was enough to give Hallbauer and Niculescu, you know, the belief that they could definitely be in this match and possibly pull off an upset.
Well, and I'm sure that beating Hanish and Zabori gave them even more belief, because they hadn't, as you said, they hadn't beaten them before, and that's a tremendous win for anyone.
Sure, and they came into it knowing they would have to take out the number two team in the country and the number one team potentially to win the national title, and that's why they're out here. And they can turn this. They can turn it. You know, I think that it's going to come up. It's got to be Niculescu. We've seen her take over matches over the years, and it's going to have to come from Gabby.
Yeah, they lost the first set yesterday, didn't they? No, they won the. Did they win the first set or did they lose the first set yesterday? They lost.
You know, and as that match went on, you know, Ellie Havel did become more comfortable out there. But I just see that, like, right here, I just see the pressure burst. All of a sudden, you look up and she's moving.
40 love.
But, you know, this is the Macy Elliott show right now, Lauren. She's getting a lot of opportunities over in that deuce court and handling it beautifully. And just, I mean, how many shot combinations, variety of shots have you seen already from Macy Elliott from that deuce court? I mean, she never hits two shots back the same way.
I mean, you're in big trouble when Elliott and Burrs look this relaxed and untroubled. But, you know, again, Hallbauer and Niculescu lost the first set yesterday,
Burrs,
and they figured
Elliott
it out. Looks like they're going to have to do the same thing today.
Exactly. Volley would like to thank the APTA, tournament host clubs, players and pros for an amazing 23-24 season. With over 1.3 million balls thrown this year, Volley creates a community to connect pros and players while giving users personalized performance insights to track progress and improve their game. Download the Volley app now by searching Volley Racket in your app store. For more information, visit getvolley.com/get-started. We'll see you next season. Thanks, Volley.
I think this is smart. They need to take a beat here, Hallbauer, Niculescu, and get their heart rate slowing a little bit and just try to, even if this set is gone, which it probably is, they can just try to find something here to start the next set with.
Shout out to Brian Fegg. He's chimed in. He lived down in Cincinnati for a while. He's a big fan of Hallbauer from Cincinnati. I think he agrees that these guys are going to have to hit attack overheads over into the Burrs at court corner, try to make her hit some shots, see if they can't open up the court a little bit that way. But Brian also thinks, and I agree, you know, the more athletic this match becomes, it feeds Elliott and Burrs' strength, and somehow, you know, if Niculescu and Hallbauer can somehow maybe, you know, tone this thing down and make it less about a movement and just see if they can play straight up. And I just don't know that how they're going to do that. I don't see that Hallbauer hits like that reset deep overhead possibly. I don't care if it's to the middle or deep at someone's feet off speed, because I think the speed at which she hits her overheads provides a beautiful opportunity to just match that and lob effortlessly the next ball pretty decently. You can see Burrs is just having fun over there, waiting for the perfect look. All right.
Got her.
An error from Macy Elliott.
15 love.
You know, like waiting in a match, you know, Brian's like, maybe they'll get some, you know, just loose errors from Burrs and Elliott. I don't see that happening. I don't think Burrs and Elliott give away points, and that's why they're number one in the women's game.
Nice volley there from Niculescu behind Elliott. All right. 30 love.
30 love.
And obviously, you cannot win a platform tennis match anywhere if you can't hold serve. And, you know, I just think the dominance of the return to serves start every point that Niculescu
40 love.
And how Balor have to face. It's brutal. It puts so much pressure on you. You know, left court, you think, oh, they're going to win an easy point. Nope.
Yeah.
40, 50. I thought so.
Lynn just stuck her paddle out, hit the shot, hit it into the kitchen, Lauren, didn't she? Beautiful hands play. Plainfield Country Club in Edison, New Jersey. She was most recently at Rock Citicus Club, did a nice job there, and is replacing, trying to fill the sneakers of Mark Bostrom, who has left Plainfield and gone to Morris County Golf Club.
Those are big sneakers.
Oh, yeah. So this was the formation, you know, at the net that worked yesterday for Hall Balor and Niculescu. And, you know, it's just, Ellie's doing a pretty good job. She let that ball drop a little bit lower, Lauren. I think if she could do that shot right there in the line.
Game, Hall Balor and Niculescu.
That could be the key, because that was what I said to you before we went on air, and I was just thinking
girl,
to myself.
Lady, sorry, new ball.
She's got to let that ball drop way lower. And if she can, then you get Lynn Burrs, you know, forced to maybe hit up a little bit on the ball where she's so used to just pouncing it. She takes that high ball and puts that ball down at your feet. I mean, 99% of the time. Quite remarkable.
New ball. Macy Elliott's going to take one.
Love 15.
Lauren, the country club's done an amazing job here in Brookline. You just got a shot of their indoor tennis facility. I mean,
love 30.
Just a beautiful, beautiful campus. I've enjoyed spending 4 days here walking around, and everywhere you look, it's just amazing. Historic club. They hosted the U.S. Open in June of 2022, and they created, you know, they created a U.S. Open type of environment here for platform tennis. Just incredible
15,
amenities 30. For all the players and fans here.
You know, on the point before, you saw Hal Bauer hit a big return and blitz. And I'm sure, you know, most of the time she hits that return so well and comes behind it. But the thing is that Burrs and Elliott are so good at defending the blitz that it's not an automatic point win for them, for Hall Bauer and Niculescu.
Again, that Elliott serve right up the middle just moved over, caused a switch in the baseline position, with Hal Bauer now finding herself over in that at court. That's where her inexperience, you know,
40,
when you haven't
30.
Played that much, you can handle all your ground strokes off the deck, but it's the screens that make this game, the sport of platform tennis, so unique, Lauren. And you know, that's where Ellie just needs to have more tournament play under her belt so she becomes much more comfortable playing balls off the screens. She's more comfortable out of the juice court than the app.
Game, Burris, Elliott.
Well, that was quite a display of the first set from our number one seeds and defending champions. And we will be right back in just a moment after these messages right here on the APTA YouTube channel presented by MyPaddle.
Most about the volley machine is I can come down here and work on my game when I can't find friends.
Volley and I have been dating for several months now, and things are getting pretty serious.
My favorite thing about the volley trainer is to be able to work on the target, contact window, and tool all in my vision.
My favorite shot with the volley trainer is the push volley.
I really love the video feature of the volley machine. It has really helped me improve.
Welcome back to the APTA Tour. We are live from the Country Club bringing you the finals of the 2024 APTA Boston Nationals. And we're starting the second set after Burris and Elliott won the first set. Gabby Niculescu is serving to start the second set.
And actually, they've played 2 points. It's love 30. The sun is out. Burris and Elliott are, the sun is very shining 40. Very brightly on them in this match. A really dominating play. You know, and it's not with spectacular shot making. It's just that they never miss, and they just, you know, are working and building the point so beautifully, both at the net and the baseline, that they look unstoppable here.
And you know, Patty, we both know that Paul Bauer and Niculescu have huge drives, but you wouldn't know it because from watching this, because Burris and Elliott are just so good at volleying their drives back and shutting it down.
As we said, you know, Niculescu has played in six finals of women's nationals. She's won three of them. She's no stranger to this big stage. And maybe with that first set out of the way, you know, maybe it just frees them up and they realize, okay, this is it. This is the last competitive set of the season. If we don't win it, and they want to play two more sets. So somehow, you know, they've got to get that mindset and just start building this just a point at a time. Don't think ahead. Forget about the past and just, you know, try to work the point. You know, one of the things Niculescu's gonna have to do, I talked about in the first set, is move around her lobs just a little bit, because I think that could free up some nice swings for Hauballer out of that deuce court.
Yeah, Niculescu's got a good lob. She can do that.
She's got to move it, though, a little bit more.
Yep.
You can see the roller Niculescu has. Just, you know, Burris can handle that shot all day long when Gabby hits it that way. Where Gabby's been really effective
15,
is taking
40.
It straight ahead where Macy Elliott is standing in the deuce court. You know, they're staying back on the serve here. Probably a really good decision. You know, and maybe they believe their way to get back in this match is from their baseline play, because they can just pounce, you know, off of Niculescu's forehand and Hauballer's forehand or her backhand. They've just got to create some more looks for themselves.
Right. I mean, those are their strengths. So it's a good idea to try to get to their strengths, make their strengths a factor.
Four.
And it's interesting, you know. Even there, I noticed the positioning, again, of Niculescu, Hallbauer. It's just they play way off the net. And so there's a lot of space in front of them available to Burrs and Elliott when they want to take it.
Missed it. You can see Burrs and Elliott, you know, they want to get this. They want to keep rolling here. They don't want to give Hallbauer, Niculescu the idea that they can get back in this match. They were up 40-love this game, and all credit to Hallbauer and Niculescu for fighting back. This is a big game.
And this is what happened. This is the moment yesterday where all of a sudden that first set was over and they're like, all right, let's go.
Advantage Burrs Elliott.
And we need the lead from Niculescu. Like, she's got to keep, you know, she pummels the ball. She's got to pick a target right there. You know what I mean? I feel like if she's a little uncertain or she's backing up slightly, then just make one of them volley versus going to an open space. Like the shot from Hallbauer right there.
Yeah.
I think.
Game, Burrs Elliott. They lead the second set 1-0. They won the first set.
I like that Hallbauer and Niculescu are clearly thinking. You know, they're changing things up. They're staying back. They're going to try to make this more of a hitting match, I think. And I think that's a good idea for them.
Said Niculescu has a couple national titles. Liz Cruz actually has 3 national titles. Flor Hannish in the field has 3 national titles. Gabby's got 2. Anna's got 2. Macy's got 2. Lynn's got 1. All-time winningest teams in women's play. Oh boy, there have been some great ones. Ari Vion, Doten Keen, Fulton Tucker, Prendergast Zink. Prendergast Hogan, they weren't bad.
They got their national title.
Cindy Prendergast, I mean, she's remarkable. She played in this tournament.
Love 15.
Cindy's played in the finals of the women's nationals. I think more than anybody in the sport. I think she's played in 14 finals in women's play.
Wow.
And she's played in, I believe, 5 finals in mixed nationals. And one of the things, you know, about that, the great players, when you know all these players and we know them by their first names and you look through, you know, the last 25 years, I always think the best players, Lauren, are the ones who have played a lot of mixed doubles as well. I think as a female competitor, you know, when you can get out there and compete against and play with against the top men, it's a huge advantage to your game. And, you know, you look at these players,
15 all.
You know, Burrs and Burrs were our winners of mixed nationals last year. Macy Elliott's a phenomenal mixed player. Niculescu has won a mixed national title with Drew Broderick. And for those players out there, I think a real good
15,
way to improve
30.
Your game as a female player is to get out on the court and be forced to play and see, you know, different shots, because I think that just helps your footwork, helps your preparation, helps a little bit of everything. I mean, Robin Fulton played here. Fulton Cup's named after her. Robin, one of the winningest players ever in our sport. She played in 24 finals of women's nationals and mixed nationals. Think about that.
Wow.
I mean,
I
what
can't.
A remarkable achievement. Flor Hannish, you know, she's played in a lot of finals so far. She's played in the finals of 5 women's nationals. She's got 3 wins. She was a finalist twice. And she's won mixed 3 times. She's got 8, you know, she's played in 8 finals of national championships. And Lauren, I just think there's no shortcut to being comfortable on the big stage in the big moment.
Right. Experience is important.
The trophy that the women will receive, the winning trophy, is named after one of our sport's greatest players ever, Deanne Tucker. Left us way too early. Deanne was a phenomenal player in women's play.
30,
mixed,
40.
A couple of different partners, won a ton of national championships. Probably in open play and senior play, the most of anybody.
Okay, break point for Hallbauer Niculescu. Again, with a huge forehand by Niculescu. I mean, it's kind of liberating for Hallbauer Niculescu. Like, they just have to hit. They just have to open their shoulders and hit, and that's their best chance.
Yep, and they need to do it early in the point. I feel like if they get that early strike, then that builds their confidence in that point.
Yeah, and then they maybe get a short volley.
Kurt Firm, yes. At advantage, Hallbauer Niculescu. Hallbauer and Niculescu. Score is 1-1, second set.
If you're Hallbauer and Niculescu right now, Lauren, do you even remember the first set?
No. Nope.
Yep.
You put it out of your mind.
Yep.
This is a whole new ball game.
They're all even right now in the second set. That's their approach. If they can stick with that, and that's the mindset they both have. They're both incredibly competitive women. Obviously, Ellie, having played on the Pro Tour for 10 years, knows a little something about stepping up to the plate. Shout out to Carol Keating, who's enjoying the action. Ticonderoga,
15 love.
Burris and Ellie have to watch out here. They can have a letdown. They're a little frustrated. That looks like them.
15 all.
And you just see the pressure right there from Burris and Elliot. You know, they're both thinking, damn, we just lost that game. Let's go. You know, and you see them going on attack mode as well. You know, that they're incredible frontrunners because
15.
Of that.
All.
Beautiful shot. The rocket just went by Burris. She just
yeah, I mean, you have to be so
low.
Fast to get out of the way of that and be able to hit it back.
Right, that's the best overhead that Niculescu could hit, and Burris just negated it with her, you know, her athleticism and racket skills.
Yeah.
And a little bit of speed. Yeah, I see a lot of communication with Hallbauer and Niculescu, Lauren, earlier in the year. You know, they kind of just played and weren't comfortable playing with each other and didn't have, like, a common mindset, where you can see they're much more in sync for this championship weekend. Really good conversations, really working together, staying together as a team.
So important. It's a small court, you're close together. Everything you do has to be in sync with your partner.
Yeah.
Macy Elliott hesitated, right? She decided she didn't want to have to hit a transition volley, so she stayed back, and then she said, oh, maybe I'll come in. But it was too late. The respect for the drives that Hallbauer and Niculescu have caused that error.
Got it, you!
Matter.
Advantage, Hallbauer and Niculescu.
Even Burris couldn't get out of the way of that two-hander,
yeah.
Two-handed backhand.
Gives Hallbauer and Niculescu a point to go up 2-1, their first lead in the match.
Love the movement from Niculescu.
Yeah,
right
got
there.
It.
We want to thank another sponsor, Neighbor,
Game,
strategic talent
Hallbauer
partner.
Hallbauer and Niculescu.
Technology transformation.
Second set, 2-1. Burris and Elliott won the first set.
Through Labor's strategic partnerships, the firm offers a range of talent services spanning advisory, niche staff augmentation, and executive search. Lauren, so this is kind of mirroring yesterday's match where,
mm-hmm.
you know, their semifinal here, Savory got off to a great start. Hallbauer and Niculescu kind of just started working their way into it a little bit, and there's a little, you know, the sun's out. There's a little ray of hope for them right now. I think, you know, as you can see, Elliott and Burris look extraordinarily comfortable to me still. But I think there's a little belief, you know, I think is back in Hallbauer and Niculescu's game.
They definitely found a little spark there. Let's see if they can build on it.
Lots of people chiming in, texting. Judy Gerard's up in Hague, New York. She's enjoying the action. My husband just texted me to tell me he got Wordle in four, Lauren, in case you were wondering.
15 love.
I told him I was proud of him.
Missed it.
You know, it's interesting. Going back to Brian Fegg's earlier, you know, insights that he shared with me, and I talked about it a little bit. You know, it's curious. He felt that Hallbauer and Niculescu need to make this a less athletic match in a way, if they could ever figure out a way to slow down.
They need to make it a hitting match. That's what they need to do. I mean, they need to make it more of a tennis match.
Right. Where I feel like they've got to pounce and just keep that pressure on. And, you know, it goes against a little bit of conventional wisdom, but I think that fuels their strengths in a way.
Yes.
But, again, you were spot on. You said it at the beginning of the match. You know, some would argue that Burris and Elliott have the best serves in the women's game, and it just negates, you know, even the greatest of returners in the sport at times.
I like what I'm seeing from Hallbauer now, though. She's you know, unless she can't block it or get a good hit on it, she's that's the problem. But she's trying to take more balls there before they go into the screen and just hit them.
Game, Burris Elliott. Second set is 2-2.
Right, tough shot right in the corner there, and it kind of looked like Hallbauer was staring right into the sun, possibly, Lauren, on that. So we're going to blame the sun on that miss.
Sounds
and it
good.
It was a damn good overhead.
Yeah. But, like, I like her taking all those balls before they get to the screen. You know, if you have to block lob it, fine. If you can hit it, hit it.
Yep, and she's got the height to block. She can block effectively out of that corner, and she doesn't care if there's a short ball. The girl's got wheels. She can cover the court. She can cover anything in front of her.
See Burris just
closing right on top of the net because she knows Hallbauer is going to drive.
When you see Niculescu and Hallbauer at the net there in that point. I mean, Ellie hit a beautiful two-handed backhand rip right through
15.
The middle of the court. The transition was on. They got the net. But then they just don't have the overhead combinations that can break down Burrs and Elliott here from what I'm seeing so far. Heather Props enjoying the action out in Cincinnati. She's so proud of Ellie Hallbauer's play and appearance here in the finals of the national championship. Ellie's the niece of Chris Underwood. There's some paddle pedigree in her family. Underwood was an early partner for Heather Props before she played for a long time with a very successful partnership with Lynn Schneeback. Niculescu trying to put some variety on her overheads, letting that ball drop low. And Ellie and Burrs, just their mindset is just wonderful here. They're just so resilient, just putting another ball back, another ball back, another ball back. They are doing exactly what Aon, our sponsor, does. They're making beautiful strategic decisions. And that's why when they attack, they make such a high percentage of shots. And right there, like over there, and I think Niculescu was just maybe
Love 30.
Suggesting to young Ellie that that might be a good time to do what's called a shift and kind of move over. And that's where they're vulnerable as a team. They haven't played that many tournaments, only four tournaments. Compared to most of the players, that's nothing. And so just those little situations, you get Burrs coming out swinging from that at-court corner on that backhand. She hit a beautiful shot, but it could have been defended with a little better positioning.
Just missed it.
15-30.
Trying to make sure there's no confusion on this point.
I think that, they're talking and 15, them huddling up is really important. They need to do it during play as well, Lauren. When you hear Hannah Sabori, you hear Elliot.
Yeah.
It's constant communication. You, me, you, me, you, me. And that's 15, what I would love to 40. Hear a little bit more from Hallbauer and Niculescu. Shout out to Griffin Kramer, enjoying the action. I saw Griffin last night. He was enjoying himself courtside at the party. Griffin was a great junior tennis player out of Connecticut. Shout out to John Oliva, enjoying the action. Chris Underwood appreciates the shout out. And she's the one telling me I've been saying her name wrong all year long. I apologize. I apologize, Ann Chris.
Oh, good move by Burrs, but well negated. Oh.
And again, kind of a wild swing from
30,
Macy
40.
Elliott, but it was the ball of life for her. She loved the look.
Oh, yeah. It was the right choice. Her eyes got wide.
Right. But the interesting thing, again, you see Hallbauer and Niculescu. Neither of them was closing in. They were just positioned around the service line and just going to try to handle the volley from there. And I just don't think that cuts it, you know, over the course of a match. You got to close in, I think. And I think that's why Elliott was a little bummed. She realized she really had a lot more room than she thought in front of her. Lauren Volley is the official sponsor.
Game, Burris Elliott. They lead the second set 3-2. They won the first set.
Volley is the official sponsor of the APTA for the 23-24 season. Backed by cutting-edge ball and player tracking technology, Volley is the innovator of the first AI-enabled racket sport training experience that simulates point play. By enabling players and pros to record sessions on the court, Volley also delivers off-the-court player analysis and support. And support, all from your phone. Download the Volley app now by searching Volley Racket in your app store. For more information, visit getvolley.com/get-started. So Macy Elliott serving up 3-2, second set. Burris and Elliott won the first set, 6-1. Valor Niculescu, our tournament number 4 seeds, trying to find a way to claw their way back in this match, Lauren.
They've done it. They've clawed their way back in. Can they get a lead?
Yes, it was out.
You know, it's not can they get a lead?
Will
Burris and Elliott allow it? I don't think so, Lauren. And what I mean by that is that's how good they are, and it's really, you know, I think when they make really good decisions, especially in transition, Burris and Elliott are unbeatable. I think, you know, they had a few little decisions there in the last couple of games, just at some moments of transition, but they're not taking their foot off the gas here. Wow, that was awfully close, that overhead.
Yeah.
30, love.
And that's where, you know, Hallbauer just responded in that moment. You know, she made the one shot, the ball came right to her backhand, and I think she thought like a pro tennis player, hit the ball, where she'll gain awareness the more she plays, where the net team is in position, and even though you may get the ball of life for your great stroke, it might not be the best choice that you can make in that
30,
situation.
30-15.
But it's tough. It's that fine line because we're talking about they need to apply pressure.
Yeah.
They need to take their shots when they get their looks. But I think you have to have your feet under you. You've got to be
left foot.
Have a little steadier starting point if you're going to pull the trigger. Sorry, that was a footfall call.
30 all.
Yeah, footfall. Her left foot, he said. Jeez, that serve is moving.
40, 30.
John Birchenall, an astute observer of the sport of platform tennis. Great player out of Beacon Hill Club. Known him for a long time. Loves watching this and... You know, he's just watching it, and he feels that, you know, Burris and Elliott, for the most part, are just so in sync at the net, and their movements are effortless, and their court coverage effortless, where Hallbauer Niculescu, he doesn't feel like they play quite into that system of coverage. You know, they're a little bit more equal opportunity when they play the net. You know, you don't see the dramatic shifting over from side to side. As a result of that, it leaves some lobs a little bit vulnerable and a little late in their decision-making as to who is going to hit the ball. Then it comes down to where you're going to hit the ball, and then you have fewer good choices at that moment. Good observation, John.
Come on!
Whoops. That was a mishandling.
That's the only shot I have of Macy
Elliott. Advantage, Hall, Bauer, and Niculescu.
Little bit of a raggedy game
Hall,
from Burrish
and
Elliott.
Three games all, second set.
All right, Cincinnati, I can just hear a standing ovation from out there right now. Three all, second set. Great position for Hauball and Niculescu all of a sudden. I mean, it's so weird. Burrish and Elliott, nothing was stopping them, and all of a sudden, you know, these guys have clawed their way back into this, and they've gotten some help from Burrish and Elliott. That's how nice they are.
They have.
I don't think they're going to be
a few drives. They've missed some drives, and they've made a few, you know, a few more mistakes, a few loose errors. And Hallbauer and Niculescu have played some good points. So that combination will get you where we are. Well, the sun is really becoming a factor. It's the second ball that Burrish couldn't see.
15 love.
Is she getting sunglasses?
She doesn't really wear. Does she wear a hat and visor, Lauren?
No, but let's see what she's getting. Something through the sun.
Yeah. I know it's bright out there, and it's that bright yellow, beautiful backdrop from the historic country club here in Brookline, Massachusetts. The yellow clubhouse up on the hill.
Sunglasses.
30 love.
It's funny. Who knew that the sun coming out would play a big factor here in the second set? But right now on that side, it's very tough to see the ball for Burrish and Elliott. There, you know, great
30,
look
15.
For Hallbauer, really, on her forehand. She's got that shot, but she's got to pick a target. She's got to pick, like, a right hip area of either player at the net. I always say, the more you rip it,
40, 15.
You got to spot it on you know, at one of the opposition's right sides versus aiming for an empty space, because, you know, you hit a ball Mach 90. An empty space can never play your out drive, but always try to position your opponents where they have to make that decision if the ball's going to be in or out. And you can get lots of volley errors just with that moment of hesitation a net team has.
Another chance for a 4-3 lead for Hallbauer.
This women's finals was to have been played last night, Lauren, as you know, and because of the rain forecast to come in and the winds last night, they threw it to this morning. A lot of fans were disappointed who came out yesterday, but the ones who are here today are loving the action.
Elliott is,
oh, come on.
Yeah.
yesterday.
New balls, players, new ball.
He was testing Hallbauer's ability to handle those rollers in the deuce court, and Hallbauer came out on top.
I mean,
they lead the second set.
Half hour ago, Lauren, you wouldn't have thought this was possible.
Burrows and Elliott won the first set.
Unbelievable turnaround for Hallbauer and Niculescu. Really happy for them, and the crowd is loving it. And you know, the best thing, a national championship. Let's get a three-setter in the finals, Lauren. What do you think?
I think I'm happy to sit here and watch all day.
Someone's asking in the chat room while they're enjoying it. They're wondering if Lynn Burse and Lynn Kiro is the same person.
In fact,
it is. I can say she is.
She got married.
Lauren, everybody's loving the action. Coach Rob up in our coach up in Canada, Toronto. Rob Mitchell brought 9 kids down to play in the Junior National Championships last weekend in New Jersey. He's enjoying the action from way up in Ontario. Kelly Fisher's out in Pittsburgh, loving the action. Thanks everyone for chiming in. Baller is feeling so much more comfortable right now, Lauren.
She's doing such a good job handling these very tough rollers in the screens. Good for her.
Good variety right there, Lauren, from Macy Elliott. See how she could change it up by, you know, attacking the overheads from different heights, and that's what, you know, that's how she can control play.
She saw Niculescu come over to help Hallbauer and then hit it behind her, and that's how she won that point. Great serve from Burrish.
Wow, that just broke down Niculescu's backhand. It's funny, Niculescu will go to like block that ball with one hand, and oftentimes, Lauren, I'm thinking, why wouldn't she use her second hand more in that situation? Because, you know, it might help handle the speed and spin from the Burrish serve.
Yeah, she lobs with one hand too on her backhand.
Right. I always feel like when you're playing defense and that ball's coming at you, that second hand setting helps you set your paddle and your wrist firmly to deflect the ball back.
40, love.
Hallbauer's got to recognize that ball might go in the crease, go right up the line. She would have been able to get that one had she done that. Good hole from Burrish.
Game, Burrish, Elliott. Second set is 4-all.
Lauren, one of these teams will have their names inscribed on that championship bowl. And the beauty of it is, you know, we talked about the first team, the first time women's nationals ever played, 1935. It took till 1975, Lauren. I don't know if you know this, till actually the names, they didn't use their husband's names. They got to use their own name. The first winners, sisters, Shirley Babington and Marty Cavanaugh, I believe, were in that championship final. And when their names appear in the history books on the APTA site of national champions, it refers to them by their first names. They played in 4 finals together as sisters. I mean, pretty phenomenal. You have the Baird brothers who won a national championship way before Steve Baird latched on to Richie Mayer, which was a phenomenal decision. Rich Mayer is here this weekend, Hall of Famer, great guy. Flew up from Atlanta for Johan's induction and to enjoy the action.
They had all 4 back for a while there.
Yeah.
Watch 15
ball just
all.
Died back there. Even Nicolescu couldn't come up with it. Must-have game for Nicolescu, Hallbauer. What do you think, Lauren? No.
Poor all game. It's no. I don't think it's a must.
Oh, I do. I think they got a hold. But the good thing is we can disagree.
You know, it's tough to serve out that game for Nationals, so nothing's a given.
Hallbauer did a good job when she had that brief appearance over there in the ad court, kept the ball in play, threw up the lob till they could pull off another switch.
And a great lob by her.
They're staring straight into the sun. I don't know if they wanted to come up to the
net. They want
to
be at the net, right.
Blake Anderson, Fairmont Country Club Pro in New Jersey, is enjoying the action. He thinks it's a must-break game for Burris and Elliott here. Interesting, different, you know, slant to it. Maybe he's feeling like they're feeling a little bit of the pressure and they need to break for their confidence.
We're all 30 all.
Actually, this point does feel like we're late in the third set. Mm-hmm. You know, you can feel it. It's crucial. Oh, what a shot from her. Yeah, she hits that snap roll.
40.
And that ball just, you know, accelerated as it came off the deck to the screen, and it just flew out on Hallbauer. She couldn't come up with it there.
Yeah, Hallbauer's been doing a good job with that roller, but that one she couldn't get.
Elliott's got to close in there. Mm. You know, that's what I talked about, her abilities to close in.
A good move, just missed the volley, but it was
game
the right play by Hallbauer.
They lead the second set 5-4. They won the first set.
All right, Patty, we're going to see if you were right, and we're going to see if Burris and Elliott can end things right here.
Yeah, you can see Missy Elliott and Lynn. They kind of have that walk, like, let's go. And I like that. You know, they took plenty of time. They're controlling the tempo right now in this match. Critical moment, obviously, and they're managing that moment beautifully. Oh. big serve from Macy Elliott to start this critical game. As you can see, Burrs and Elliott are looking right into the sun here. Let's see if that plays into this.
Love 15 all.
Another miss serve.
30 all.
Okay, still 2 points from the match.
She's going big.
30, 40.
Now, and here's the push serve.
She did win a national championship with the push serve.
Yeah, yeah.
Came right into it, and really smart decision. Right there to just go to that. She knows that's the one she can always make. Point well. Ellie did a really good job there. Just couldn't finish it off.
Deuce.
Back to Deuce. Huge sigh of relief for Burrs and Elliott here.
Let's see what serve we're going to get. Push.
Yeah, great rip.
Advantage, Hallbauer and Niculescu.
Niculescu. You know, Patty, I had a feeling. It's just hard to serve that
game,
this match out. I had a feeling there might be another few twister turns yet.
You know, it's interesting in that second set, Tomas Christian sent me a text, and he's pulling for the team of Burrs and Elliott. He's pulling for all four women, but he's got a special allegiance to the team of Burrs and Elliott, and he just felt like they were backing off a little bit on their volleys. And they're getting caught allowing way too many shots, a little bit off the net, and with the firepower from Niculescu and Hallbauer here, you know, they're getting those dipping shots low, just getting a little bit of room, getting some errors out of Elliott and Burrs.
Love 15.
Saw this a lot yesterday in the comeback against Hanish Zabori in the second set, where they opted to just really stay back, start the point from back there, give Burrs and Elliott the net, especially when they're looking right in the sun.
The sun.
And I think Hallbauer feels much more comfortable playing the baseline than playing the net, I think. You know, this is where she can rely on her tennis background and those beautiful ground strokes where she can attack forehand or backhand all day long. Shots from
30.
Carson Elliott just makes it so tough to defend from the baseline.
Yeah, and they're going to test her back there. They're going to keep going at her and making her defend in those screens.
Tremendously athletic play, Lauren. They defend extraordinary shots, and they just make it look so routine.
Right. It's so not easy what they're doing.
She just loves to unload on that overhead. She hits 170 miles an hour. She's going to try to hit the next one 80 miles an hour. That's the problem. You've got to make sure you don't hit it to that panel and can allow a burst to attack straight at
you. I agree.
Come on!
Good aggressive play from Niculescu there to help and cut off that first
15-40.
Burris thought she was hitting it to the open court, that slice, and Niculescu moved right over and gave it to her.
Really good play from Niculescu to recognize that she had to hit the ball because she had Burris way out of position.
Wow, how they didn't hit each other there, I don't know. Nice
great
move.
Love the play.
Yeah.
I don't know. Game Burris Elliott.
All right, Patty.
They lead the second set 6-5. They won the first set.
Yeah. Burris now gets a chance to serve it out.
That's right. Burris tries to do what Elliott wasn't successful at. She got broken there, trying to serve this match out at 5-4, and now Burris gets her shot. 6-5 in this second set. We're at Brookline, Mass. at the Country Club. APTA National. national championships. Appreciative crowd there, beautiful backdrop for this amazing event the APTA has pulled off, with a ton of help from everyone here at the Country Club. They've really been gracious guests and provided every amenity. Really, really an amazing effort. Lynn Burris to try to serve out the mat for a second straight national championship.
Another good move from Hall Bauer.
Love 15.
A little risky move. I loved it, and it paid off. The players call the lines, and it's only if it's questioned, will the umpire make an overrule or make the call? He won't call the ball out if it's out. The player has to call the ball out.
Yes, I agree. Love 30.
Serve was out. Love 30.
Lauren, you were spot on right. It is so hard to serve this thing out.
It's crazy, right? I mean, the mental part of the game is just crazy.
What would Yogi Berra say? It's 90% physical and 90% mental?
Yes, something like that.
Two break points here for Hall Baller Nicolescu to get it into a second set tiebreak.
Nice get. Missed it.
Are opening up the door
Hall
here
Bauer
a little bit.
Hall Bauer and Nicolescu.
They certainly are.
6-6.
You know, Hall Bauer and Nicolescu have done a great job, you know, working their way back into this match. And they did get a little bit more help than I thought Burris and Elliott would really give to them. So we're here we are, Nicolescu to start the tiebreaker. Looking right into the sun.
Yeah, I mean, you get the feeling if this were just a practice match, this match would have been over a long time ago, but there's a lot riding on it, and nerves do funny things.
One love.
And now, Burris and Elliott, who both had trouble with their serve in the past two games, trying to serve it out. What serves do they hit? Do they hit their big serves, which is what got them to this winning position, or is Elliott going to hit her push serve, which the last one she hit to Hall Bauer got crammed down her throat? She is going to stick with the push serve.
Yeah, she closed in for that first volley, got another step in, handled that return serve beautifully.
Yeah, I mean, fortunately for Elliott, she has a tremendous first volley, so.
Baller got way backed up, and rather than let that ball hit a screen and, you know, so that it could absorb the pacing, the shot slowed down. She tried to block that ball, couldn't do it.
Did you hit her?
Great drive from Nicolescu. She did hit her opponent. She apologized.
Two.
Yeah, no, I mean, that's totally legit. I didn't see why I couldn't see it.
Yeah, she just got hit. You weren't the only one who couldn't see it. Burris couldn't see it either.
Burris couldn't see it either, exactly.
I think Burris will return the favor soon. Wow, what a deep overhead right there from Burris. So close. and I call this time Gabby time, because I've seen Gabby over the years just pull out some remarkable shot making when everything's on the line. That's Gabby time. She loves this moment.
She does. And she can take it over.
Dave Arthur's down in Richmond. He's nervous. He's feeling, he's antsy. He's pacing. He's walking around the couch doing laps here. He's so nervous for them.
But as you can see, Burrish and Elliott are going to try very hard not to let Niculescu in here.
One,
not
three.
To give it a chance to take over. That's the problem, right? You get one ball and you feel like you have to really do something with it.
Four, serving one.
Right, you just don't know when your next opportunity is going to come, so you go for it early, you know, and she just went for a little too much over that way. I would have loved to have just seen her take that ball back in the middle of the court and just keep testing the volley, because they've gotten some volley errors from Burrish and Elliott here in the second set. It's Lynn Burrish serving. Soft off speed overhead, just caught.
5-1.
And Burrish and Elliott up 5-1 in this tiebreaker. They're looking unstoppable at this point. We're going to be joined here by the one and only Brad Easterbrook. I mean, this match is going on so long, Lauren, I need a break. I'm going to hand it over to Brad to help me out for a couple minutes here.
Patty, happy to ease your stress, give you the break you need in this incredible women's final. As Patty
just in time.
Heads out. Yep, for the possible interview, although it's not over yet.
But a whole handful of match points here for Burrish and Elliott.
This would be another chapter in a great championship story of Gabby Niculescu if she could pull this one off. All right, so 6-1. And a lot of it, Lauren, it seemed like all the energy it took, they're fighting their way through this set the entire time, Albar and Niculescu. And in this tiebreaker, they're fighting hard too, but it feels like there was almost just like moments where it was just fighting so hard the whole time, hard to keep it together the entire way. Last second dig. Burrish didn't think she was going to get it. Popped it long. Oh, there it is. Game, set, and match. Burrish Elliott, back-to-back championships. Wow.
Burrish and Elliott.
Well earned. They were the best team all season, certainly in the second half of the season. They didn't lose, and they're well-deserved champions, Macy Elliott and Lynn Burrish.
And all these folks, there's a great hug between those two friends. They put in the work, put in the effort, they watch the film, they practice all the time, and it shows on the court, and it showed from the first half of the season to the second, and they dominated that second half, and you're so right.
And a good effort from Ellie Hallbauer and Gabby Niculescu. They got creamed in the first set, and they fought their way back in, they changed their strategy a little bit, they did whatever they could, and they were right there in the second set, Brad.
No, they really were, and you could see it. They made it difficult, and the pressure was real and there for Berrettinelli. You could start to feel they were feeling it.
Yeah.
And
just
couldn't quite get that, you know, get it to that third set. That would have been the crucial moment. It took so much effort just to get it to that tiebreaker. But all around great match and a great season on the women's side. Incredible stuff, and only onward and upward for Ellie Halbauer, who improved dramatically this season.
Getting set up for the trophy presentation here that we're going to listen to and watch.
Yeah, we can see all that going on. And it was just a great match, a great atmosphere out there. A lot of fans. There was a whole crew out here from Wilton, Connecticut, and other places. And just, you know, meant a lot to all the players. They put in all that work. Gabby's so fiery. I love it. You know, the first set, as you were saying, it's almost like they couldn't get their feet underneath them quick enough, and it was over in kind of the blink of an eye. They were down 5-love in maybe, what, 20 minutes more?
Maybe yeah. 20 minutes, yeah.
And then from that point on, they really found their way into the match and made the adjustments they needed to do. And kudos to Gabby. Is one of the best fighters and champions out there. Nicolescu, Halbauer, gosh, she's got some real firepower there. Real firepower.
Patty Hogan's ready to interview the runner-up.
All right, we're going to toss it over to Patty out there.
What an amazing day here at Brookline, Massachusetts at the Country Club. Ellie and Gabby, great tournament. So proud of you guys. Phenomenal win in your semifinals over Hanish Zabori. Came up a little bit short against their number one team in the country, Burns and Elliott. But you guys should be so proud of yourselves. Ellie, congratulations on your first final.
Thank you. I feel like it was a really great tournament. It's been a lot of fun playing with Gabby. And I know they had a great game plan today, and they executed it well.
Well, you should be proud of yourself. You've got a long way. You've got a long time in this sport. Yeah, phenomenal for such an early start in your career. Congratulations.
Thank you so much.
And Gabby, three national titles so far. This is your, you've been in the finals six times.
Wow.
Is this your seventh?
Yeah, I mean.
And Gabby, I mean, you're a great champion, a phenomenal player, one of our game's best players ever. Everybody knows Gabby, and you played a remarkable tournament here and came up a little bit short. I know that's really disappointing, but I hope you can appreciate the takeaway from getting here and clawing your way back in that match. It was a great show.
Yep, I feel like it's a definite privilege to be back in the final. I'm more grateful for just playing with Ellie. Thank you for the fans for coming out here and supporting so nicely. You know, positive supporting on the great cheering is always helpful. We wish we came up on top. I really had the different words I was prepared to say today. But I hope to be back in one more final.
I have a feeling you'll be back.
Multiple.
Congrats, you guys.
Thank you.
Great play this weekend.
Thank you so much.
To the Reading Country Club, my family, Ellie's family.
My family, yeah.
Kenwood Country Club. We wouldn't be able to do it without them.
Thank you very much.
So nice.
Amazing women.
Thank you.
And our champions. What a wicked, great final here in Boston, Brookline at the Country Club. Congratulations, Lynn and Macy, on your repeat. Why don't we start today with you, Lynn? How does it feel?
I'm very tired. I can go.
Okay, you know what? We're going to go to Macy. Macy's never short for words. We're going to let Lynn get it together here. Macy, how cool is this? Great play there.
This is amazing. Gabby and Ellie are such phenomenal players, and we knew this was going to be a fun match for the crowd here on a Sunday, and the Country Club put on a great setup here, so this was just, I mean, how blessed are we to even be here?
We are blessed. This was an amazing play. You guys are awesome. Lynn, you have it together?
Sure.
I mean, you always have it together. Phenomenal play, Lynn. That was great.
Thank you.
Congrats on your second title with Macy.
Thank you. All I can say is it's very exciting. You know, coming into this again this year, the first half of the season wasn't too great, but I'm really proud of how we bounced back and, you know, ended with some momentum. And I'm really happy that we managed to play a really good match today. There were some ups and downs, but really happy to get a second title with my partner.
Just amazing play. 9 finals this year, 5 victories, and the biggest one of all on the biggest stage here at the Country Club in Brookline. Congratulations.
Thank you very, very much.
Hi. So I'm Tiernan Cavana, president of the APTA board, and I just wanted to take this opportunity to thank our amazing national sponsors, Volley, Fusion, obviously our membership. Without you all, we couldn't put on the tour. I want to thank, obviously, umpire Rick Eddy, our APTA staff, and all the fans out here, and especially the Country Club. These guys have put on an amazing event. And with that, I'm going to introduce Nathaniel Mason and Jamie McCleary and go through the trophy presentation.
Tremendous trophy presentation there. It was really great to see how much it means. Lynn Burrows took a moment to collect herself there in the interview, and just a great season for those guys. Macy Elliott, Lynn Burrows, and capped off with another back-to-back national championships. And yeah. You can't script it much better than that, Lauren.
No, and they're the team to beat next year, and it'll be exciting to see who can come up, if anyone can come up with anything to take them down.
Yeah, it's amazing how the game sort of works, right? For a couple of years, Hanish Tabori were basically untouchable, right?
Yep.
And they were in the beginning of this season almost as well. And then a subtle adjustment. We all knew the talent was there on various levels, and see the improvement out of teams like Morgan and Sikora, you know, who pushed them in the other round. And what I found from Burrows and Elliott that was great this year, it wasn't easy all the way. They had to fight their way through the beginning of the season a little bit. Yep. And even in yesterday's semifinal, you know, it was there was tough moments. They were down 3-love. They dug deep. they weathered some mistakes and even here a lot of pressure there at the end. So it was tremendous, and it's interesting, you know, and amazing to see them dig like that all the time through there. And Ellie Haubaugh, you know, the sky's the limit for her as well. I mean, she's really only been, you can really say this was her real coming out party last year. She did play some, but
yeah,
she's really announced herself now. So next year is going to be fantastic seeing these teams as they look to improve. And as Zabori and Hanisch, you know, I'm sure they're watching film and getting ready to deal with all this for next year and come back even stronger than they were this year.
Thank you.
I'm sure they are.
All right, so that's a wrap, I think, here for our 2024 Women's Nationals. A tremendous final, tremendous tournament, and a tremendous job from all the people here at the Country Club here in Brookline, Massachusetts. We're going to have the men's final coming up. When, Jake? We're going to do 1 o'clock, it's scheduled for? Oh, it's as soon as possible.
Yeah.
So the men's final is not going to be going on at 1 o'clock. It's coming up right after this one. We'll clear the presentation thing, and the men are going right on. Maybe we'll say 15 minutes to a half hour, I would guess, probably. So stay tuned. Order some Uber Eats. Do your thing. Get ready for the men's final. Lauren, that was great.
All right, thanks, Brad.
Every day, big decisions are made without full information. Overloaded by data, compounded by complexity, better decisions are made in the light. With clarity and confidence. Aon is in the business of better decisions.
Most about the volley machine is I can come down here and work on my game when I can't find friends.
Volley and I have been dating for several months now, and things are getting pretty serious.
My favorite thing about the volley trainer is to be able to work on the target, contact window, and tool all in my vision.
My favorite shot with the volley trainer is the push volley.
I really love the video feature of the volley machine. It has really helped me improve.